Hi, my name is Marie Cruz and I'm a Senior Developer Advocate at Grafana Labs. In this another beginner-friendly video tutorial, I'll discuss histogram visualizations in Grafana. By the end of this tutorial, you should know when to use and how to configure a histogram to visualize your data in Grafana. A histogram is a graphical representation of the distribution of your numerical data. It groups the values into different buckets and counts how many values fall into each bucket. Each of the bars you see here represent a bucket. The y-axis represents the count of values that fall into each bucket, while the x-axis represents the different bucket range. You can use a histogram to visualize and analyze data distribution over a specific time range to see how frequently certain values occur. You can also use a histogram to identify any outliers in your data distribution. To help you in this tutorial, I'll use the Grafana test data source, which comes built in with Grafana. The Grafana test data source has different scenarios, so you can easily experiment with visualizing the data, which is great if you are a Grafana beginner. With that explanation out of the way, let's get started. First, I'll add a new visualization to a dashboard and select the Grafana test data source. Then, under the visualization dropdown, I'm going to select histogram. Histograms work best with time series or a table result with one or more numerical fields. To demonstrate how histograms work with time series, I'm going to use the random walk scenario. To find out the underlying data for this scenario, I can click the Query Inspector button and then select Data, which will display the time series data used for this particular scenario. I can configure the visualization a bit more by providing a panel title and also setting the bucket size and the bucket offset. Bucket size refers to the range of each bucket used to group data. It's set to auto by default, but you can change it to your desired value. If I provide an offset of 5, you can see that the range of each bucket has changed to be of multiple of 5. On the other hand, the bucket offset refers to the adjustment made to the starting point or boundary of each bucket. If I change the bucket offset from 0 to 1, the starting point will adjust by 1 and so on. Currently, you can't see the offset changing in the x-axis because of a bug, but you can see that the boundaries of each bucket were updating. I added the link to the bug in the video description below if you want to know more about the issue. Now, if you have a table result with one or more numerical field, this can also be easily visualized as a histogram. To do that, I'm going to change my scenario from random walk to a CSV file and then select the weight height CSV. Let's look at the underlying data again by clicking the Query Inspector and then the data. So here we have a table of different heights and weights. To visualize the two distributions easily, you can toggle which distribution you would like to view, or you can even update the chart color to your preference. And there you have it. In this beginner-friendly video tutorial, I've shown you how to configure a histogram to visualize your data in Grafana. Check out our Grafana documentation if you want to know more about histograms by checking the video description below. I hope you found this video useful, and if you do, please let us know in the comments below. And as always, happy visualizing!